Consultations are ongoing, and of course it is going to be an inclusive system. We are in talks and we have a relationship, a working relationship with the Americans about the security arrangement. The outside checkposts are in our control, and inside is under the control of the United States forces, and they're in constant contact with one another. It is very unfortunate for people to be rushing to the airport the way they are at the moment. I think it would have been much better, because we have announced general amnesty for everyone, the security forces from senior to the junior level. And this fear or this hysteria that has taken place is unfounded. The developments were so fast that all people were taken by surprise. And when we entered Kabul, and it was not pre-planned, because we announced initially that we do not want to enter Kabul and we want to reach a political solution before making a joint and inclusive government. But what happened was that the security forces left and they abandoned their places, and we were forced to ask our forces to enter and take over security. The point of intra-Afghan talks was precisely that we come to an agreement about what those rights actually entail. Sharia law is known to everyone, and there's no ambiguities about the rights of women, the rights of men. Our foremost priority is discipline in our own ranks, and not enforcing laws on others, but enforcing it on ourselves first, and then giving it as an example for the rest of society to follow suit. Well, I don't think people believe we are terrorists. I think it's just the war on terror. It was just a term coined by the United States, and anyone that did not fall in line were labeled terrorists.